and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
My name is Father Alonzo Cox. I serve as Diocesan Director for Ministries at African American Catholics and the Diocesan Coordinator for Vicariate for Black Catholic Concerns. And I take this opportunity to welcome all of you here to the Immaculate Conception Center as we celebrate Black History Month. For the last few years, we've been working with the Diocese of Rockville Center, and so on behalf of Ms. Garcelle Wilimowski and all of her team and all of the people who work with her in her office, I take this opportunity to say welcome as we celebrate the gift of who we are as Black Catholics. I also take this opportunity to thank all of our clergy who are here today, most especially our main celebrant, Bishop Neil Tiedemann, who serves as the vicar for the Vicariate. Bishop Tiedemann, thank you so much for being here with us this afternoon. We are also very blessed to have some of our auxiliary bishops here as well, too. Bishop Guy Sansaricq, retired auxiliary bishop of the Diocese of Brooklyn. Bishop Octavio Cisneros, currently our auxiliary bishop for the Diocese of Brooklyn, pastor of the parish of Holy Child Jesus in Richmond Hill. And Bishop Richard Henning, who is the auxiliary bishop in the Diocese of Rockville Center. Thank you so much for being here with us this afternoon, along with our priests and deacons from both Brooklyn and Rockville Center. May this afternoon be filled with God's love and God's mercy as we lift our minds and hearts and voices to the Lord as we celebrate Black History Month.
The Word of God addresses us today. Placed before us is life and death, good and evil. We must make a choice, and yet at times we know we have failed to make the right choice, and so we ask God's pardon and forgiveness.
Mercy, mercy, God, mercy.
O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. And we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. are mature, not a wisdom of this age, nor of the rulers of this age who are passing away. Rather, we speak God's wisdom, mysterious, hidden, which God predetermined before the ages for our glory, and which none of the rulers of this age knew, for if they had known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what eye has not seen, and ear has not heard, and what has not entered the human heart, what God has prepared for those who love him, this God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit scrutinizes everything, even the depths of God. My brothers and sisters, the word of our God.
Thanks be to God.
speak to us about wisdom. And I have to be very honest with you. I'm not truly wise. I'm not the person filled with the most amount of wisdom. But all throughout today, as I was preaching in my own parish today for Sunday Mass, and as I was preparing for this homily this afternoon, I thought of the wisest person that I knew. I thought of the wisest person that is actually watching me from her place in the kingdom of heaven. And that's my grandmother. My grandmother was from the South, and she had the Southern drawl to her. She moved to Brooklyn with her husband, with her children, and she was super Catholic. And she loved the church. And there were times in her life that the church didn't love her because she was black. And she taught us one thing. And she taught us that it didn't matter whether we were liked by white people, by black people, by Hispanic people, by Asian people. The only thing that mattered is that we were loved by the Lord. Yeah. And I think of her today, and I hear her voice today as she wants me and as she's calling me to speak to you today about wisdom. And all three of our readings today reflect on what wisdom truly is. What does it mean to be wise? What does it mean to be a person filled with wisdom? I am a Brooklynite, born and raised in Brooklyn. And God called me to priesthood very young. I wanted to be a priest since I was 13 years old. And I came here, right after high school, to this institution, Cathedral Seminary Residence, while going to St. John's University. And I spent four of the happiest years of my life discerning my vocation, learning about how God loved me, learning about how God would call me to serve his holy people in the Diocese of Brooklyn. And it was here in this institution that God touched my heart. And I remember very vividly the day that I graduated from this institution, from this place. There was a big convocation here. Bishop Cisneros, then Monsignor Cisneros, was the rector of the seminary. And I was privileged and honored to serve as class valedictorian here at this pulpit. And I remember vividly my grandmother and my parents and my sister and my cousins all being here, sitting in this section right over here. And I remember getting my diploma from Bishop DiMarzio, and the next day going back to St. John's and getting my degree in philosophy from St. John's University. And I remember being very proud. And I remember going to my grandmother with my chest out, pumped up, that her grandson had just graduated from college and was now moving on to the major seminary in Huntington. And she looked at me, and she looked at my diploma, and she said to me, "Boy, that don't make you wise. Who do you think you are?" And she said to me again, and she reminded me again, all the diplomas in the world, all the paper that you may have, that doesn't make you wise. It doesn't make you who you are. God created you to be who you are as a young black man. Living out God's love, living out God's mercy. And that, my sisters and brothers, is why we are here today, to live out who we are as black Catholics. We're reminded in today's second reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, we speak a wisdom to those who are mature, not a wisdom of this age. Oh my goodness. Paul could not have been more right than he is today. We do not speak a wisdom of this world. We do not speak a wisdom that this society believes to be true. I don't know about you, but I turn on the TV, I open up the newspaper, and I see all these people with all these letters behind their name trying to tell me what the truth is.
Lord. And Jesus is telling us today that, you know, we have the commandments, but do we live them out? It's great for us to be able to speak the commandments. It's great for us to be able to recite the commandments from beginning to end. But my sisters and brothers, we are being challenged today to live them out. As brothers and sisters united in Christ, we are called this afternoon to look at who we are as witnesses, as disciples, as stewards of the living Lord. We speak God's wisdom, mysterious, hidden, which God predetermined before the ages for our glory. That, my sisters and brothers, is what brings us to church. To be able to speak God's wisdom. To be able to live God's wisdom. And to not become distracted or lured by what society believes us to believe, or wants us to believe as truth or as their own sense of wisdom. I have been blessed over these last 6 years to serve as pastor of the parish of St. Martin de Porres in Bedford-Stuyvesant. Three churches that are historically Black and Catholic to the very core. I am so blessed to serve as a successor to priests like Father Martin Carr. I am blessed to be able to serve in a parish that stood up for their rights as Black Catholics. I am blessed to be able to serve in a parish that continues to unite themselves into the mystery that is Jesus, knowing and never forgetting that they are Black and that they are Catholic.
Amen.
We come together today to celebrate Black History Month. And we come together today to give thanks and praise to God for our ancestors. Our ancestors who paved the way for us to be able to be here today. I think of my own grandmother, who wasn't able to go to Mass back in the South because she was Black. She was unable to attend Mass because of the color of her skin. I thank God each and every single day for the example that she gave to me and to my family. And that is what we celebrate. But guess what, my sisters and brothers? The struggle isn't over. It ain't over. I'm only 37 years old, and I haven't lived through the horror stories of the 60s. But I lived through the horror stories of the 2020s. I lived through the horror stories of being told that I can't do certain things because of the color of my skin, that I can't achieve the things that I want because you're Black and because you're from a certain area. Guess what? I proved them wrong. Yeah. And we will continue to prove them wrong. We live in a world where we need to continue to build bridges, not walls. We live in a world where we need to allow God's love and God's mercy to truly be at work within our society and to not be allured by the sin of division and racism. Because guess what, folks? Racism still exists today in the year 2020. We still hear of our own brothers and sisters who are being persecuted because of the color of their skin and not looked upon as brothers and sisters in Christ. We speak a wisdom to those who are mature, not a wisdom of this age. We still have a lot more work to do. A lot more work to do. But my sisters and brothers, with God's grace, we can do it. Because we live by faith, not by sight. We are people of faith, we are people of hope, and we are people we continue to place God's love at the forefront of who we are. It's the very essence, my sisters and brothers, of what makes us as special and beautiful as God created us to be. How beautiful God has created us to be. To be black and to be authentically Catholic. And to allow Jesus to be at the center of our lives. What eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has prepared for those who love Him. My sisters and brothers, we love the Lord. We love the Lord, and the Lord loves us. Unconditionally, unreservedly, without blemish. God loves us so much that He gave His only begotten Son to free us from our sins and to lead us to the eternal kingdom of heaven. And Jesus isn't looking at the color of our skin, but at the very depths of our hearts. Better than any of these other people with the degrees that they may have behind their names. That is why we are here today. To give honor and glory and praise to our God. And to never forget who we are. And to never forget the ancestors who paved the way for us to be here today. Let us pray that by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, God will give us the strength and courage that we need to be truly wise. Not looking on what we have, not looking on the physical material things that we have, but the very depths of our hearts. To bring his love, to bring His mercy, to bring His presence to all those whom we encounter, and to not be dissuaded or distracted by anything else. Nothing else in this world will ever fulfill what Jesus has for us. Amen. Nothing else in this world will feed us in the way that Jesus feeds us. Amen. Nothing else in this world will ever fulfill our needs but Jesus the Savior. Let us continue to keep our eyes fixated on Him as we strive each and every single day to preach and to teach and to minister in His name, proclaiming Him as Savior and King who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
écrit par nous-mêmes. Par commencer, montrer les mains à respect, nous guérir une couleur, pour nous finir à toute violence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
En nuestras parroquias aumenten más su crecimiento y respaldo a nuestros familiares en su esfuerzo en vivir una vida religiosa, ya sea en el ministerio a la iglesia o como padres de familia.
We pray to the Lord.
Come on, here, say excuse me or something.
Sorry.
Thank you.
so that from the rising the sun would set in, a pure sacrifice might be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, giving you thanks and praise. He broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Giving you chalice, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Gracious. scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
full realization of the responsibilities of your office. Are you willing and ready to assume office?
I'm Lori Haynes.
I'm Elba Alexander.
I'm Lori Alexander.
I'm Elba Haynes.
I'm Betty Lee.
And I, Betty Gaffney,
in the presence of those who are
here today, to pledge myself to fulfill faithfully the duties of the office to which I have been elected. I will obey the Constitution and the bylaws of our order,
national, state, district, or local.
I will ever work for harmony
and the cooperation
of both work and the health
and the social work.
I hereby declare to duly install Knights of Peter Claver, Ladies Auxiliary, Father Jeffrey B. Gillen, Court 333, to fulfill your term of office or serve until your successor has been duly elected and installed.
Because Sister Thea has been with us for this. We are from Brooklyn, we are from Queens, we are from Nassau, and we are from Suffolk. We are Haitian, we are Nigerian, we are African American, and we are Caribbean American. And we are European American, whether we're Irish or Italian, just like Sister Thea said, bringing us all together. Because you know what? We are all African anyway.
As I mentioned, I do hope that all of you will be able to go downstairs. Also, in your worship aids, there are some dates to remember, most especially Kujenga. Kujenga is a retreat for our young people that happens every single year, and we have some information regarding Kujenga, so hopefully you'll be able to send some of your young people, even if they're from Nassau and Suffolk County. We do have the retreat out in Huntington, at the Seminary of the Immaculate Conception in Huntington, so I do hope that you'll consider sending some of our young people, some of your young people, to encounter the Lord of Heaven and Earth during this weekend of Kujenga. May the Lord continue to bless you and heal you, and may his face shine upon you and be gracious to you, and may he bless us each and every single day of our lives.
Amen. Amen.